We've done the Empress, and now it's time to move on quite naturally to the Emperor. And this is where it gets a bit weird, okay? Because things changed, because we've been kind of going through the letters of the alphabet: Aleph, Beth, Gimel, Day, Gimeth, Aleph, Bet, Gimel, Dalet, Hey. So we should be doing Hey next. But when Aleister Crowley and his honeymoon with his first wife, in spending it in the Great Pyramid, as you would, he was given the Book of the Law through his wife, Rose Kelly. And in there, in part of that, it says, Tzaddi is not the star. Now, the letter Tzaddi, TZ, is the star. But he says, Tzaddi is not the star. So to kind of fulfill that, he had to work out, if Tzaddi is not the star, then there is another card that also is misattributed. And in the end, he fell on the Emperor. So here's the thing. In Gematria, Tolu the Lamb and Tzaddi, they have the same number. And it might be that he got this from Gematria. He kind of forgot about it and it came through his subconscious thing, because a lot of stuff that gets communicated from spirits often gets filtered through your own layers of perception. His wife, Rose Kelly, his new wife, Rose Kelly, you know, she wouldn't have known Kabbalistic attributions, but he certainly did. So the Emperor is not Hay, as it should be. It's Tzaddi, okay? Right, so you can see that at the bottom of the card. And Crowley was never really happy with changing things around either. So he kind of half does the job in this book, in the Book of Thoth. So Tzaddi is now Aries in the zodiac, sign ruled by Mars, and the sun is exalted. And he says the sign is thus a combination of energy in its most material form with the idea of authority. So we have this idea, and you know, he looks pretty authoritarian, doesn't he? You know, he's kind of macho. And he's also looking at, wrong way around, he's looking at the queen, okay? They're facing each other, right? So they're kind of mirroring the sephirots of Hokmah and Bina. Hokmah is the male energy, Bina is the feminine energy. So he's the empress, and he's the emperor, and she's the empress. So in the Attu mnemonics, so it goes Aleph, Bet, Gimel, Dalet, and then Tzaddi. It's out of sequence. Okay, it should be Hay. He says, Sire and Scepter, Emperor and King, of all things immortal, hail him, Lord of Spring. Of course, Aries heralds the entrance of the vernal equinox into spring. So it's very much this energy. And it's fire and it's red, and you've got all that kind of sort of thing. But the thing is that Aries is the beginning of stuff. It doesn't maintain things. Okay. The Emperor is about holding on, getting power, holding on there, staying as long, and then dying eventually into old age, hopefully, unless someone kills him. But the Emperor starts stuff, the Aries starts stuff, doesn't finish it. It's the beginning of things. So there's a lot of toing and froing that goes on with these cards as well, as you can see. So let's see what the verse says for the Emperor. So it's number four. It says four on there. Okay. Fourth. The fifth card, numbered fours. It says, pour water on thyself. Thus shalt thou be a fountain of the universe. Find thou thyself in every star. Achieve thou every possibility. That can't be right. And it's not. He's transposed the verse for Aquarius. Okay. Into there. So what's the one because he gives it away, because the meanings of the card for number four are war, contrast, victory, strife, ambition, originality, overweening confidence and megalomania, quarrelsomeness, energy, vigor, stubbornness, impracticability, rashness, ill temper. That's not the star card. What's the star card? Star card is number 18. And for the star card, it says, use all thine energy to rule thy thought. Burn up thy thought as the phoenix. That sounds a bit more like fire, doesn't it? And then for the meaning of that card, it says hope, unexpected help, clearness of vision, realization of possibility, spiritual insight with bad aspects, error of judgment, dreaminess, disappointment. That's the star card. So, you know, is, you know, how much was he just didn't bother to change it, or he deliberately left it as it is, or just, you know, it doesn't match up. The Emperor is those qualities of power, authority, and everything that goes with it. It's not about hope or salvation, but it's the phoenix. The phoenix is a transformation card. It's to do with the mass of the phoenix as well, which is alluded to in the Empress card. Tricky stuff. For those Thelemites among you, you can hold your breath. I'm not going to divulge any secrets here. You're safe for now. So what does he say also about the Emperor? He brings in this idea again, matching up with the Empress, the whole alchemical thing of Rajas, Tamas and Sattva, okay, with two and three. And this idea of this figure is the alchemical symbol of sulfur. You can kind of see it in the way his leg is crossed over the other leg. Now, of course, in the Hangman, you can see that kind of thing that way too. So there's something interesting going on there. So again, he mentions the influence of, hence such symbols as the bee and the fleur-de-lis. The bee and the fleur-de-lis also appear in the Empress card too. And he says his shield represents a two-headed eagle crowned with a crimson disc. He also had the two-headed eagle in here, in the Empress as well, somewhere too. It was a white eagle. I'm sure it said two-headed eagle somewhere. So there's an element of duality and contradiction, because we have male and female again, and these energies transferring between them. And he talks about the white light which he sends upon him indicates the position of this card in the Tree of Life. His authority is derived from Chokmah, the creative wisdom, the word, and exerted upon Tipperath, the organized man. Forgot to talk about that, didn't I? He added in at the end, thank God, or otherwise I'll have forgotten. So the Emperor goes from Chokmah, number two, down to number six, Tipperath, from there to the center. So we had the High Priestess going down from Keter to the center, Tipperath, and the Emperor also goes to this position as well. So now, the next card is the Hierophant.